Hello and welcome to My Disney Brain. Today is December the 20th. This is Kelly, and you've reached podcast number 26. Today we're going to be talking about Disney Plus, and I have two of my favorite guests in the studio today, my daughters Nia and Imani, and they're going to join me, and we're going to talk about how much fun we have been having playing around and watching new and old Disney content on Disney Plus. So if you happen to be a person who is in limbo in terms of deciding if you want to pull the trigger on that $6.99 a month membership with Disney Plus, we may be able to persuade you today. Before we do that, though, I want to thank you for joining us and continuing to support the podcast. We are excited to have you aboard, and today's going to prove to be a very informative show. So hang around all the way through. Before we get going, I always like to provide you with our social media contact points, touch points. So you can follow us throughout the week after you listen to our podcast, and as our next podcast is being created, you'll have some information from My Disney Brain in the interim. So we've got a few places where you can find us. Of course, our website is mydisneybrain.com, mydisneybrain.com, BRAIN.com, where there's a plethora of information that can update you on what's going on in the park. It can assist you with planning and so much more. So please check us out there and remember to subscribe. The two other touch points are Facebook and Instagram. So you can simply search us by My Disney Brain, BRAIN, and we should come up very easily. Please like us and follow us there, as we're always posting new and updated information. So with no further ado, we're just going to kind of jump into it, because the show is probably going to be pretty detailed because we're all excited to get going here. So again, thank you for joining us. We're going to talk about Disney Plus. So hang tight. We'll be right back.
Each of us has a dream, a heart's desire.
All right, folks, let's get started. Let's start at the beginning. So let's assume that you've no idea what Disney Plus is. You've been perhaps incarcerated or in a cave or in a coma for the last few months since D23.
That's really dark.
Yeah.
Really dark. All right. So what if all three of those things
have
happened? Well,
the reason I say that is because you know as well as I do that Disney does Disney does quite a bit of advertising. Let's just put it that way, almost to the point of spamming you. It was like that with Galaxy's Edge. It's like that now with the upcoming, you know, Christmas season and the new Star Wars that just opened today, which I'm super excited about, which we're going to go see. And that's a whole nother podcast. But I want to explain to you what Disney Plus is in the event that you do not know. So I'm assuming that you have at least one streaming service, a streaming service being video content that you can access via app, via your smart device or your TV, smart TV. So that is a streaming service. Disney Plus is simply an on-demand, ad-free streaming service. And most Disney fans knew about this after D23 this year. Certainly we did, and we put in our order very early to make sure that we could have access to it on November 12th, which was the launch date. So it's been out a little over a month now, and we're just going to give you some feedback today in terms of what we've been doing with it, what we think about it, et cetera, et cetera. So now the streaming service has tons and tons of movies and shows from Disney, from Pixar, Marvel, Star Wars, National Geographic, and 20th Century Fox. These are all obviously Disney properties, okay? So the thing that, and I'm going to kind of get a little ahead of myself, but the thing that I first thought about when I heard about Disney Plus was the ability to be able to access some of the more nostalgia, some of the things that I haven't seen in a long, long time. We're going to talk about that in a few minutes. So that alone was enough for me to pull the trigger on this streaming service. Now, we reported several podcasts ago when this initially came out. For those of you who don't know, Disney is also the prime stakeholder in Hulu. So if you go to DisneyPlus.com, where you can sign up, and by the way, I'm not an affiliate of Disney Plus or Disney, and I'm not getting any commission. I'm not promoting it. So I'm just telling you where you can go in order to actually get or verify the information that we're giving you. And also, if you do decide to sign up, you can do it there. And there's a free trial for the Disney Plus membership. The streaming service, Disney Plus, you have a 7-day free trial. How much does it cost? It costs $6.99 a month. Now, if you have Netflix, if you have Hulu, and if you have Amazon Prime, Disney Plus, that is the cheapest I've seen. I'm not sure what Apple, what is Apple's called? Apple CTV or something like that? I don't have Apple.
I don't know.
I don't know how much it costs, but I don't think it's $6.99. So if you just want to get Disney Plus along, it's $6.99 a month, and you get a 7-day free trial. There's also a package where you can combine this with Hulu, Disney Plus, ESPN Plus. If you don't have Hulu and you like ESPN, go for it. If you have Hulu already, obviously, what's the point? I don't know who really is watching ESPN these days. I hate to say it, it's not what it used to be. But anyway, it's $12.99 a month. And you can go to DisneyPlus.com and check it out. Now, as we get started, we're just going to kind of start off by giving you our idea of what we thought it was versus what it is. Okay, so we're just going to kind of go around the table. Again, I have my daughters here with me, Imani, who is 24, and Nia, who is 12. So I expect we're going to have some diverse commentary to offer those families that are there who have more than one child in different age groups. You'll be able to get some feedback from the different age groups. So you can, you know, you can kind of compare and contrast. So which one of you ladies want to go first?
Me. I was born first.
Hey, hey, hey. I'm the favorite. It's okay.
All right.
Moving on.
So Disney Plus. You said what was my expectation?
Yeah, so when we first started talking about it, like over in the summer, mm-hmm. we ordered it, I don't know, 2 or 3 months before, whenever we could initially order it, we ordered it. What did you think it was going to be, and does it meet your expectation?
Okay, I thought it was going to be just like Disney Netflix, mm-hmm. essentially. And I wasn't expecting it to have the new content that it has. And I also wasn't expecting it to literally have all the Disney content that it has. So it exceeded my expectations because it provided way more than I thought they would. Because, like, for me, when I think of Disney classics and collections, my span goes back maybe as far as like Snow White, Cinderella, Jungle Book, like along those lines. Mm-hmm. But Disney Plus has all of that and everything else that came before it.
Yeah, I don't think a lot of people who are not Disney nerds realize the intellectual properties that Disney actually owns. So, for example, ESPN, National Geographic. Most people know Pixar and Star Wars because they're, you know, who doesn't know Toy Story and Star Wars? But most people don't realize that you're going to get all this 20th Century Fox stuff and the Marvel stuff. And people who may not be Disney fans are big time Marvel fans. So you got your Spider-Man followers, you got your Superman and all that kind of jazz. And so all of that stuff is on, all that Avengers stuff is on there. So I'm with you there. So Neil, what did you think initially? Did you understand what it was? And if so, Is it meeting your expectations so far?
Yes and no, only because I had no expectations.
Do you watch it every day? I bet you do.
I don't.
You watch some part of it every day?
I don't.
No part?
You have a smart TV in your room, and what do you, you're not, you don't.
I watch Netflix and I watch Hulu, and I watch pretty much the same shows, but when Disney Plus came out, I had absolutely no expectation. Like, at first, I just thought it was another streaming service like Netflix or Hulu, so I was like, okay, this is, what do we need more of these for? But when it came out, I will say it did exceed my expectations because it was really nice to see stuff on there that I hadn't seen in, like, ages.
So. You're 12.
Like what? Like, what's an example?
The Game Plan for any of my younger
Disney Yeah, that's fans. One of your favorite movies.
Yeah, it's because I would stay up till like 3 o'clock in the morning waiting for it to come on. And then it wouldn't come on and I'd just be tired for the rest of the day.
So you didn't realize that Disney, that was a Disney movie. And when you saw
it. I knew it was a Disney movie. I just hadn't seen it forever and I didn't think it would be on there.
Yeah. Okay, what else?
That's pretty much it. I had no expectations at first because it was just another stream.
You had no expectations.
But they exceeded your expectations.
That's why I say yes and no before I started this.
Okay.
That's not how this works.
Well, all right.
That's not how any of this works.
So, you asked for my
opinion. Yeah, and that's fine. That's fine. That's fine. So for me, I had really high expectations. And even the high expectations I had, they were exceeded because when you finally get access to the platform, so I have obviously more history with Disney than the girls. So things like Cinderella, the original Cinderella, Peter Pan, things that were in the Disney vault, Mary Poppins and The Sound of Music and Apple Dumpling Gang, things like that, that when I was a little boy, that you just couldn't find anywhere. You know, initially, Netflix did carry some Disney content. So I remember, I don't know how long ago it was, maybe about 8 months ago, I was watching Zootopia like every other day just because I like to watch it on Netflix. And then one day I went to go watch it and it was completely gone. Like, you know how you search and you're like, was I watching this on Hulu or Netflix? Right. So, like, where was I watching this? And I knew it was Netflix, and then all of a sudden it's gone. And then, of course, we started getting word that Disney is pulling their stuff because they were planning to do this thing called Disney Plus. So fewer and fewer Disney items, Disney movies were showing up on Netflix. Now, one of the things that when I first saw the platform, I thought, man, this is really, really neat because – excuse me, the way the platform is built and the way is very user friendly. So I was talking about this on another podcast, but what I said, I think it was Nicole and Corey, we were doing a whole nother podcast, but we started talking about Disney Plus, and I said, you know what, the very first time I signed on November the 12th, I created my profile. And I shared the access with my kids, of course, so that they can create their profiles and not be looking at movies on mine so the algorithm won't think I want to watch. What was the name of yours?
The Game Plan.
The Game Plan or things similar to The Game Plan.
Hey, you probably would have liked The Game
Plan. Yeah, it's okay, but I don't want that on my algorithm. So I created my profile and sent out the information to my kids so they can create their own. But I didn't even watch anything the first day. The first day, the only thing that I did was go through and just kind of get familiar with the platform, but also pulled up some movies that I knew I would want to watch, and I started putting them in my watch list. And as I was putting them in my watch list, I would select a movie, and when you go down to the bottom, it has additional movies that, you know, you may like that are in this same, you know, genre. So I started just compiling, you know, Apple Bottom Gang and Sound of Music, Old Yellow. All these things just started just popping up. Swiss Family Robinson, things I haven't seen in years. And I just started putting it on my watch list. So for me, Disney Plus really exceeded my expectation. But the only thing it had to do was actually just to come out in order to do that. I knew what it was going to be. I knew it was going to, they were going to open a vault. I knew I was going to be able to have, this is something I've always wanted. So even when you guys were small, one of the things that I've always attempted to do was to create a library of sorts of content, particularly movies, that we can just access on a whim. So, you know, we went from VHS to DVD, from DVD to like YouTube and streaming and stuff like that. But the streaming services, particularly Disney, it gives you access to your favorite content seamlessly at the push of a button. So if I wanted to watch Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Man Tell No Tales, I literally, it'll take me 10 seconds to have it up and going. I don't have to go and find the DVD. I don't have to, God knows what we were doing with the VHS. Once you finally found the tape, then you got to rewind it and all this other jazz. The ability just to go in, pull up the content, and show it is, I guess, revolutionary is too big a word since we've had Netflix and Hulu for the longest. But for me,
what you want to talk about with TV?
Netflix would be like, really?
No, well, I'm just saying, for me, sometimes I go to Netflix. I got to be honest. I don't want to talk down about Netflix because we still have Netflix.
Hashtag we love Netflix.
Period.
We do. We do love Netflix. But I sometimes feel overwhelmed.
Oh, yeah.
Do you ever feel like that? Like you're scrolling and you're like, yeah, I want to watch that. But wait, I didn't know they had this. And then you're just like, well, what else they got?
Yeah.
I spend 15 minutes looking at stuff like.
Yeah, more. I feel like that more recently. They've started adding some really good old stuff on Netflix.
I just, you know what I do? When I put stuff on my list, I force myself to stay. I don't scroll down more than 3 rows on Netflix. Because once you go down past 3 rows,
you get lost.
You're
going
to
get lost.
The abyss of Netflix.
Yeah, you're just in the hot, this is trending, hot. And since you watch this, and I'll be like, geez,
Daddy,
man, look at all this.
You don't watch nothing that's trending. You don't like stuff that's trending.
Well,
trending, hot,
I don't know.
Lukewarm,
coming
soon.
We're watching different trending
trailers.
Things. But I do like Netflix, but I tell you, sometimes I get lost. With Disney Plus, there is a lot of content, but I'm more familiar with it. And I can select it, and I feel more comfortable because I know here's the trepidation with Netflix.
Ooh, that SAT word there. Say that again.
And it's the same trepidation when you select. So you guys are going out on a date, and he's hoping that you like this movie because he's already paid for the ticket. So there's some level of responsibility if the movie sucks, right? He's like, dude, why we sit here and wasted 2.5 hours of my life on a terrible movie? So you know how it is when we sit down with your mom and I've selected the movie.
And then you fall asleep in the first 5 minutes.
All right, well, forget the falling asleep part. But is the movie good or not? Like, oh, it was okay. If it's a really good movie, then you're like, oh, man, it's awesome. So at Netflix, a lot of times I don't really know. It just looks good from the cover and maybe the trailer. And I think, okay, it's something to watch. But then you get halfway through, you're like,
this was dumb.
Yeah, but with Disney Plus, I know a lot of this stuff. And I can sit down. And although I've seen a lot of this stuff before, like Pirates and stuff like that, I'm as excited to watch it again. But anyway, we got a little bit off course. But that was our initial overview and initial thoughts about it. So again, for those folks who don't know anything about Disney Plus, you don't have it and you're kind of weighing your options because, number one, you probably already have at least 2 streaming services. I'm going to venture to say you have 3, and I'll tell you why. Most folks order from Amazon. And I don't know what the numbers are, but I would venture to say that of the Amazon users and customers, probably 35 to 40% are Prime members.
Yeah, probably half.
I'm thinking half, but I'm just kind of, I'm going to err on the side of caution. So I would say between 35 and 40%, meaning if you're a Prime member of Amazon, you already have Amazon Prime, so you have that by default, the video. So I think most people have Netflix, most people have Hulu, and most people have Amazon Prime. So we're going to go around the table now, and we're just going to kind of compare and contrast. What do we have with Disney Plus? Do you like it more or better, less or greater than the streaming services that we have? And if you had to get rid of one, which one would it be? So we have Netflix. We talked a little bit about Netflix already. We have Hulu, and we have Amazon Prime. Just think about the ones you watch the most, which I know is probably Netflix. I think most people have Netflix and Hulu because those are the first ones that came out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just by default, they were the first ones that came out.
Yep.
Yeah. I agree.
So what do you guys think? We have Netflix. We have Hulu. Of course, we have Amazon Prime. Which ones do you guys watch? Which ones do you think have the best content? And then if you had to compare it to Disney Plus, which one do you think you would replace it with?
Well, of the 17 questions that you just asked, okay, so which one out of Hulu, Amazon, and Netflix do I like the most? Netflix, because I like binge watching. If I had to get rid of one to replace it with Disney Plus, purely based on streaming services, no other features, I would get rid of Amazon. Why? Because there's really only one Prime original that I just really like watching. So just simply based on streaming services, I would end up using it the least. So I would get rid of it and replace it with Disney Plus.
So you watch Amazon Prime the least?
Yeah.
Because
it only has one show on there that I just really like to watch, and it's a Prime original, so I can't find it anywhere else.
So from a content side, it just doesn't offer you as many options.
Right.
Okay. I mean, that's fair. That's fair. And we have it by default because we're Prime members.
Because we're Prime members. Yeah. So, but not including those other features, just based on streaming, I would do that.
And Netflix, just to throw this in there before Nia is thinking about her answer, Netflix is, well, let me just say it like this. You're not going to find any rated R or PG, what is it, NC-17, stuff like that on Disney Plus.
No.
So Netflix is going to offer you a wider range of content. And I think you understand that.
Yeah.
Disney is family-oriented. It's family-related. The stuff that came out the vault wasn't Orange is the New Black.
Right.
It was Peter Pan and things that more nostalgic Disney Walt stuff that, mm-hmm. that just can't be duplicated. And I think that's why so many people were excited about it and signed up for it. Yeah. And will continue to subscribe to it.
Yeah, I agree.
So, Miss Nia, what are your thoughts? Which ones do you watch the most?
I would probably watch all of them equally. If I had to choose one, I would say Hulu. Not even Netflix, Hulu. Because there's a specific certain shows on Netflix that I will watch, and all of them are on my list. And
so you would get rid of Hulu before?
No, I mean, I watch
Hulu. She said she
watched
Hulu the most.
Oh, okay. I wasn't understanding. Because it has actual shows that we like.
Yeah.
That's the thing I like over Netflix. I actually think I like Hulu better than Netflix.
Just because I don't think I have the patience to sit through a whole movie, especially if I'm like multitasking.
But it's more than just movies on Netflix.
I know that, but it's
Hulu's platform is easier to me to navigate because for me because I get overwhelmed with that thing that keeps going and going. I mean, there's so many titles.
You
it's
don't
like,
know where you stopped and started. You'd be like, wait.
Yeah. At least Hulu gives you like, one at a time.
Yeah.
And there's a list. And if you want to go further, you say, okay, see more or something like that. With that row of movies, it seems endless.
Yeah.
And it's like some of the rows have the same movies on them.
Yeah.
And you're like,
you spend more time looking for a movie than you do watching one.
I absolutely do. Anytime I go to Netflix, it's going to be minimum 10, 15 minutes before I figure out what I want to watch.
If I don't have it on
my watch list.
I always know what I want to watch if I'm watching Netflix.
No, you may, but then guess what? Okay, let's say, you may know or think you know what you want to watch. You pull up Netflix. It's always going to have something new, an advertisement at the top.
Yeah.
It's going to be like, oh, this came out, and this is a new Netflix original, blah, blah. So, oh, I wonder what that is. And you watch that trailer, so there's 2 minutes, and then, then it refers you to something, and then say, since you watched this, then you may like these. It's to me.
You got to stay focused. You got to tunnel vision. I get on Netflix, I'm watching The Office.
But see, that's how I feel about Disney Plus. When I go to Disney Plus, I know what they have out there.
Yeah.
And they only have one row of new content.
Yeah, that's true.
Everything else, I know what it's going to be. It's just a matter of finding it and hitting play. And we're going to talk about some of the new content. I'm going to suggest some stuff to you. If you are Disney Plus users already, you probably know what I'm talking about already. But, yeah, so it takes me a while to navigate through Netflix. So you're saying you would like Hulu better?
Yeah.
Do you watch Amazon Prime at all?
I watch one show on Amazon Prime, and when the next season of another show comes out, that'll be two. That is it.
So do you think for your age group that there is variety on Amazon Prime? Because quite honestly, when I see Amazon Prime, you know what I think of?
What?
I don't know if it's just because of the way the platform's built, and every time it comes up, I just always think of... Right. I think of Downton Abbey.
Downton Abbey?
Yeah.
Do you completely worship the
name? Because, I did.
Yeah, just...
because I always want to say Downtown
Abbey. No, it's Downtown. You know they made a movie?
Yeah. They did. It's on PBS. Like your mom watches all the time. But every time I pull it up, it seems like there are... E-covers.
Yeah. Made it. Wear suits with the briefcases.
Right. It's always like some PBS show, something they're promoting that looks like it could be on PBS.
Well, PBS has great shows, okay?
Well, they do.
And Netflix carries PBS shows because Call the Midwife is on Netflix, and that's a great show.
Well, my point is for her age group.
Oh, yeah. No, don't watch
that. I
don't
see
that.
No,
you'd be surprised because things like All American or Nancy Drew, like the older... type shows that people my age would watch are on there. So if you can find your shows on there, yes, we do watch them.
Do you guys, you have your own profiles on there, right?
No. Well, I don't use your Prime account.
Oh, okay.
Whatever's on
there. I'm just trying to figure out why it always comes up in mine. It's like Father Brown.
Because mom uses yours too. And Father Brown is on Netflix, Daddy.
Father Brown's on Amazon Prime.
I bet you it's on Netflix.
And I'm going to tell you the one of the things that I do like that's on Amazon Prime that I'm bananas about and I absolutely love, and I have the DVD set, and I was praying that HBO was going to bring this back, and then they brought it back for a movie and killed the main character, and I was like...
Wow, way to...
Yeah.
Spoiler alert!
So if they haven't seen it yet, my absolute...
Fast forward.
Right.
I mean, outside of Disney, my absolute favorite series... HBO, hands down, is the best show they ever did was Deadwood.
Therefore saying
oh my God.
Of your other shows are trash.
No, I didn't say it was trash. But
out
Deadwood,
of the park, bro. Just
they did. Job. They knocked it out of the park. Deadwood is my show. And when they stopped it, we're going to get off track. We should be talking about Disney Plus. But when they stopped it, it was because of contract negotiations with some of the main characters. And I was just like, this is gold. Pay the man. Like, come back for another. They did three seasons.
Disney, pick it up. Pick up Deadwood.
This is not family oriented content.
Bring it back. Wait a minute.
Bring it back.
This is not family oriented content.
He said pay the people, so
the
pay them.
Old West. This was South Dakota back in the 1800s. No. Disney's not.
That'll be a variety of content. There you go, right there.
Your kid's first word is going to be something very unexpected.
So, all right, so let's get back on course. So, you were saying that Hulu is your favorite. Streaming channel.
Yep.
All right. So you've been watching stuff on Disney Plus. If you had to replace one of the three, which one would you replace it with?
Amazon. I mean,
hands down.
Amazon just Prime. Because I use Netflix for other stuff. Hulu, like I said, is my favorite. But even though Amazon gives you that upper class, sophisticated shows with the whole nice platform and everything, I would replace that with Disney Plus so that I can see my childhood stuff, and then I can go to Netflix for any other comedies that Disney wouldn't carry because they're not Disney's genre.
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure out how we got Amazon being sophisticated. Training Day is on Amazon. That's not sophisticated.
I don't know how you're seeing this stuff, because when we pull it up, It really is. The majority of stuff that I see, besides Deadwood, because I'd be watching it sometimes, because I watch it sometimes.
Nice. That was good.
I know. Well, you know what? I have to tell you this really quickly. It made me remember something. We had a listener who sent me an email and she commented on one of our podcast posts. Mm-hmm. And she was very nice. I can't remember what her tagline is. But she was recanting a comment and some commentary between myself and one of the guests that was on, Nicole. Mm-hmm. And we were talking about something. But anyway, she recanted it word for word. And I looked at my English. I was like, oh, my.
Like, she typed everything you said.
Yeah.
And you read it back.
I read it back. And I was like, because here's what I know that I do. When I'm really excited about something, like I go really into Moonville, I go really into South Carolina.
So you talk like me, basically. Everything that you tell me not to say.
No, not really. But maybe.
So I can't say finna, but you talk about some weird.
No, sometimes I do say that. And I'm going to tell you what happened. When she put that comment on there, she was saying that, what did I say? I said something like, oh, that's a whole nother show.
Oh, she put a whole nother?
Yes.
That's nice.
Oh, and when I saw that, I was like,
was it like comma N-O-T-H-E-R?
Yeah, it was parentheses. It was, yeah, exactly like I probably said. And here's what I know is because Nicole and I were talking, sometimes we get to going into areas as parents we get, you know, kind of excited about. And I know I said it because I say it sometimes when I get excited. And I said to myself, if I'm going to keep doing this, I'm going to have to slow down.
I have to
down.
Use all my degrees.
Right. This guy has a master's. Somebody need to check his master's because he can't speak no good English.
Yeah.
So anyway, so your summary is that basically you would replace Amazon Prime with Disney Plus.
Yes.
So you would keep Hulu and Netflix. I agree with that. I think Jeff is going to have some work to do to keep up with Apple, Disney Plus, Netflix, and Hulu, because Amazon Prime is suffering, in my opinion, with the lack of content, particularly original content.
Yeah.
I don't know where you go to buy stuff because Netflix has bought everything they can buy in terms of rights and content from everybody. It's because they knew Disney was going to come to the market. And so when they were losing stuff like Disney, they were having to replace it with other good content. Mm-hmm. And the other thing is Netflix has so many good originals.
Yeah, they do. They do have some good originals.
Netflix has so many good originals. But here's why Disney is so great. Back in the 30s.
Oh, wow. Lord. Okay.
No, you're going to understand this when I tell you this. Back in the 30s and the 40s. Well, of course you can go because that's when Walt started all this.
He was creating then.
Yes. Original content. Steamboat Willie and all this stuff. That is only Disney.
Yeah.
Do you know why your cable bill, most people's cable bill is high?
No.
Because they want Hulu. They want, I'm not, not Hulu. They want HBO.
Okay.
HBO costs, if you just got Stars or Cinemax or something crazy like that, you wouldn't be paying that much. But in order to get what you want, you can't get Game of Thrones any other place besides HBO. You couldn't get Sopranos. You couldn't get The Wire. HBO, that was theirs.
Yeah.
You couldn't watch it on NBC or somewhere else. You could only get it off of HBO. And that is the value in having your own content. And so who has more content than Disney? No one.
Nobody.
At least in that genre. At least in that family-friendly genre with the cartoons, original Cinderella, the Snow White and Seven Dwarfs, all that stuff that Walt was building all those years, all that stuff was locked away in the Disney vault, and nobody could get to it but Disney. And so if you want to see it, guess what? You got to go get it from them.
True.
And that's the genius of it. And so that's, in my opinion, is where Amazon is hurting right now because they don't have original content like that. Now, I know because everybody is doing it now. When you go to any of these streaming services, Hulu, Netflix, wherever, you're going to see Netflix original, Hulu originals, all this other kind of stuff. That just means you can only see it here.
Yeah.
Orange is the New Black, if you like that, the only place you're going to see that is on Netflix.
Yes.
It's not on regular TV?
Nope.
No. No. And Netflix has come out with some really good originals.
Yeah.
And jumping forward, I'm hopeful that Disney's going to come out with more. For example, when Disney launched, Disney said, okay, we're going to give you all what you thought you was going to get in this old. But when they start playing those commercials for The Mandalorian, I was like, oh, my God, I know I'm going to get it now. Because Star Wars, and this is a new prequel,
yeah,
and it has lived up to the hype. I'm like a chapter behind right now, and I can't wait to go watch it. It is excellent.
But wait, there's more.
It is, and that's what I'm hoping. Because here's what I like. For those of you who want to get an idea of some of the content that's out there, obviously you know the stuff that was in the vault, Jungle Book, Peter Pan, and all these other things. But some newer content, Mandalorian, if you don't know what that is, just go to YouTube, type in Mandalorian. You can see some of the trailers. But it's basically a prequel to all of the Star Wars episodes.
Yeah, it's responsible for all the new Baby Yoda memes.
Yeah,
Baby Yoda is the only reason I still
if you wonder where Baby Yoda came from, there's where it came from. So check that trailer out. But for those of you who know, you know how awesome it is. Now, that's new content from Disney.
Yeah.
And it's not a movie. It is
a series.
Yep.
So I initially thought it was going to be a movie. The fact that it's a series, and I know that they're already shooting a second season, is super, super awesome.
Oh, are they really?
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. So you have stuff like that that's out there. And then on top of that, you have a documentary that was done called Imagineering. If you are a Disney nerd and you like the behind-the-scenes stuff and you love to learn and see how Walt did all this and what Imagineering actually is, I absolutely love this particular documentary because it goes into detail about specifics that happen that you won't necessarily know about unless you watch something like this. I mean, you're hearing from ex-executives, ex-presidents. You're hearing from folks who have transitioned, like Marty Sklar, who actually stood on the X at Disney World, you know, with Walt, why it was a swamp. And he was responsible for pushing the tables together and making the Epcot. And he worked with Walt. He worked with Walt's brother. All this stuff. You're hearing this inside stuff, and it's really, really well produced. Angela Bassett is the narrator, and it cannot be a better documentary done. And I've seen a lot of stuff on Disney, but this is really well done. And then in addition to that, they now launched about 2 weeks ago something called a Day at Disney, where they follow people who work at Disney and just kind of highlight what it is they do that adds value to, you know, to Disney, be it at the parks, behind the scenes, et cetera, et cetera. So there's a lot of really good new Disney content that's out there. Now, one of the things that I wanted my daughters to talk to you guys about was how they are experiencing the old and the new. And you guys know what I'm talking about, like with the That's So Raven.
Mm-hmm.
So, Imani, when you were small, you loved That's So Raven.
Yes.
And now, what's the new show, Nia, that you like?
With Raven's Raven Home.
Is the mom?
I don't really watch that, but it's decent.
Raven's Home.
No, I'm not saying, like, it's bad or anything. Like, I have seen it, and I will say that it was a very good spinoff. So, yes.
It's called Raven's Home.
So, Nia evidently doesn't watch it, but...
I've watched a few episodes, but they're in, like, the third season? I haven't really been on, like, actual TV. I watch recordings of, like, Fresh Prince or The Soul Man when they come on MTV, but, like...
Okay.
So clearly, she's not the best person to ask, but you can ask me. That's why we're both here. Yes.
So you've seen the That's So Raven and what is it called?
And Raven's Home. Yes.
To me, that's pretty great because, you see, we saw Raven.
As a teenager.
Simone. Well, I saw her as a baby in Cosby Show when she first started doing there.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, she really was. And then she got her own Disney show and... Imani used to watch it, I mean, all the time.
Yeah.
And then you look up, and now she's got kids, and now it's still on Disney.
Yeah.
And it's like two different generations of kids are being able to enjoy this stuff. How was that? Is it kind of crazy to watch that, or is it?
When it first came out, and I, because when Disney Plus first came out, I was stuck on watching all of the Lion Kings because I'm a Lion King fanatic. But then when I finally got past all the Lion Kings and saw that, hey, there's a Disney Channel stuff on here too, and I saw like the Lizzie McGuire's and the Even Stevens and the That's So Raven, I was like, whoa, I am like 10 years old all over again. Because that's one of the reasons why I was so excited when we moved into, well, this hasn't been a new house in a long time, but when we moved into the new house, air quotes, we had cable and we had Disney Channel. I was like, yep, Channel 64, me all day, every day. And it was.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was watching That's So Raven, so it's pretty cool. And when I heard—
Is that the first time at Disney Channel we moved here?
Yeah. We did not have no. Oh no, because I would be so excited to go to my friend's house and watch Disney Channel.
I didn't realize that. We had cable at the other house.
We did not have Disney Channel.
I didn't realize.
I had WB Kids on Saturday.
I did not realize that.
So that was pretty neat. And then when they did come out with Raven's Home, I watched a couple episodes of it just because I was so into That's So Raven. And I think they did a good job with the spinoff, with her having the kids. And one of them has the psychic ability just like she did. And seeing her and, well, for people who watched That's So Raven back in the day, you know, she had a crush on Devon. So they ended up having kids. And then Chelsea's back in it. And it's just really cool to watch as somebody who's seen the before and after.
You know, one of the things that's cool about it is that a lot of times, like with Hannah Montana, when—
Yeah, Hannah Montana's on there too.
What's the artist name that plays Hannah Montana?
Miley Cyrus.
Yeah.
When she got a certain age, she lost her mind a little bit, but when she got to be a certain age, Disney, I think some of the kids, when they get a certain age, they just go off and do adult stuff.
Yeah.
Well, the thing that I like about them bringing Raven back is that it continues.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The story continues. So obviously the focus for Disney is always on the kids.
Yeah.
But with that particular story, I thought it was cool because it just continues and you get a chance to kind of see into her adult life. Because I don't know if it would have been cool. What's that show you used to watch was it Jesse?
Oh, that was a great show. I like that show.
Is that on there?
I think, yeah, it is.
I cried when— Okay, nothing. Nope, never mind. Okay.
When it was over?
Yeah, because I missed it.
Yeah, it's a good show, but it's on Disney Plus now. It's on Disney Plus now.
Yeah, well, I knew it was one of the ones you used to watch, but yeah, I just think it's cool because you're able to access content like this at the drop of a hat, and most families— you know, Magic Kingdom, Epcot, Animal Kingdom, all of Disney World, Disneyland, these places are filled with families a lot of the time.
Yeah.
And so content like this is family oriented. And when you have little kids, they come up on this stuff. And whether you want to believe it or not, I mean, you're coming up on it too, because 9 times out of 10, you're watching the TV with the kid. I hope,
yeah.
You know, they just ain't locked in their room the whole time. At least ours were not. We were watching a lot of times. We were watching things together, particularly like Lion King. And when Disney movies came out, we were going to the movies together to watch this stuff. So, yeah, Imani came up on Lion King, but we all did. You know, we all did.
Yeah.
So
I didn't realize there was a Lion King 1.5.
Yes, there is, and it's good. We got it somewhere on DVD.
Yeah, we have
DVDs. I know, we watched it.
Yeah. All right, so we've got a few more questions we're going to run through, and then we're going to kind of wrap up our talk on Disney+. Hopefully, we're adding some valuable content, and you can kind of begin to, you know, ascertain whether or not Disney+ is for you. So the next question, guys, is going to be, what's your favorite thing about Disney+? And name one thing that's your favorite and then one thing that could be improved. Like, I wish it had X.
Okay. My favorite thing.
Yeah, start with your favorite, though.
My favorite thing is that it has all the Disney Channel classics on it, like the actual Disney Channel stuff on it that I remember and I'm used to seeing. And then, if I could change something,
Change something or add something.
Okay, so it's an addition.
It can be anyway. It can be improved.
I would add, because on Disney Plus they do have the Proud Family movie, but they don't have the Proud Family series. I would add the series in addition to the movie.
Oh, okay. I didn't realize that. Nia, what's your favorite thing first?
My favorite thing, My favorite thing is that everything is on there, because I remember when, like, I was still heavy on watching Disney Channel. Mm-hmm. If a new episode of something came out, it would tell you Wednesday, November 19th at 8. You had to sit in front of the TV.
You had to wait
November
for
19th at 8.
So now you can binge watch without having to wait.
Yeah, and I thought that was pretty cool, because I hated just, like, watching the clock and you're still out and you're like, I need to get home.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what about what's somewhere it can be improved?
Two things. Well, the first thing, I don't know if they can really improve that, because then it's not Disney Plus.
What?
I was going to say a wider range of, like, variety stuff, but then it's not Disney Plus.
Like more risque type stuff?
Not necessarily risque, but yes, older.
Just groups. Older.
Yeah.
Yeah. I do think, well, I think you, some of the live action stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's applicable.
Yeah, I think that's as far as it's going to go, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think you're going to see, well, let me just put it like this. If Disney does make anything that could be an NCR, NC-17, something like that, it probably would show up on Netflix or somewhere like that.
I don't think they would go that far. I think at most Disney's going to do PG-13 max.
What is NC-17? Max.
NC-17 is like...
Like you're not supposed to be there unless you're 17.
Oh, is that what that means?
Yeah. You don't necessarily have to have a parent, but you have to be 17.
Oh.
No children under 17. I think that's what NC means.
Oh.
I would have to look it up. Don't take my word for that. I just literally made that up.
So. Well, you did a good job. It was seamless.
All right. So for me,
played it off.
My favorite thing about Disney Plus is that it exists.
it actually exists.
Because I was waiting for this for so many years. You just have no idea how cumbersome my life has been with content. You guys have seen the number of videotapes that I have, the number of DVDs that I have, and it's always in an effort to be able to access a good movie so for family time we could all sit and watch it, right?
Yes.
And it's always been at least a setup, you know, the projector's got to get warm, I got to find a DVD, I got to make sure.
Wait, the projector has to get warm?
Yeah, you just gonna turn the projector on and all of a sudden it works. It's like cranking the car and turning the heat on. It ain't no dragon underneath the. So, to have an app, have a platform on my smart device, my phone or my tablet, my laptop, or my smart TV, to simply be able to type in Old Yeller, it literally comes up.
Yeller.
Yeah.
Old Yeller.
I don't know
what
you're saying.
It says Old Yeller.
I don't think, I guarantee, pull it up on your app right now.
Okay.
I guarantee it says Old Yeller.
Okay, so I'm pulling up Pirates of the Caribbean. How about that? I'm pulling up Pirates of the Caribbean. Dead Man Tell No Tales, and literally I just hit play. I don't have to put anything into anything. I don't have to do anything except for select it. And that's just awesome. It is absolutely awesome. And I've waited so long for it. Streaming, of course, and I just described streaming, but Disney Plus is better because it's. I know that it's stuff on there that I actually want to see that I'm really, really passionate about.
It kind of sounds like you're more passionate about the birth of Disney than your children.
Right.
You know, you're really passionate right now.
About this.
It's really intense. I feel like we're competing for your love right now. I'm not going to lie.
I don't know how those two things even go together.
We kid.
All right, so here we go. So what is one thing that I would change about it? Or one way to improve? Mm-hmm. I think the only way to improve on this platform is to offer more content.
Like just in general?
In general. I don't care if you open the vault deeper and bring out stuff we never even knew existed. Because this Imagineering thing, the content that's on this Imagineering is footage that I don't think general public has seen before. I've seen so many documentaries on Disney. I've never seen some of these interviews. I've never seen some of this time-lapse stuff about Disneyland and different things like that. Mm. And I know Disney tapes everything.
Yeah.
So, I mean, open up the vault more and bring out more of the stuff that we don't even know exists. I mean, they're shooting behind the scenes of the building of Pandora. They're shooting stuff... where they're creating and shooting Star Wars new movies and stuff like that. They've got content on Leia. What was the lady that passed away that played Leia? Yeah, what was her real name?
I don't know. You know, I don't know.
I can't remember her name. But you know what I'm saying? I know they have content and visuals and stuff like that on that. And even the older stuff. I would love to see. You ever seen that those clips of Walt's riding around his yard on his train?
No.
He had a train in his yard. He would ride on the train around the yard. He would play with the kids. He'd take the kids to school. Walt took his kids to school every day before he went to office.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. And I know there's footage and stuff about you very rarely see some stuff. Open it deeper. Bring out more of that stuff because, mm-hmm. I mean, people would pay. Well, I don't want to give them any ideas, but $6.99.
Yeah.
Man, that's... For what we're getting is like...
I was surprised at the price when I first heard about it. I didn't think that was going to be true.
Well, you know, one of the things I thought they had reported, but it turns out it was wrong, that they said if you were already a Hulu subscriber that you could bundle yours.
Yeah, I've heard that too.
But they didn't make it an option, so we basically had
not
to...
Yet.
Not yet, anyway. So anyway, our last question before I summarize this is going to be about... What's our favorite so far? What have you found that was like, man, this was worth it? What was your favorite thing? What's the one thing that you found out there, either your favorite show or your favorite movie?
Daddy, I think I know what yours is.
Okay, but I want to do mine.
No.
Okay, so a movie, I don't think it's considered a movie, but more of like a short, like one of those short films.
Why are those Pixar shorts so sad?
They're depressing.
Oh, my God.
Wow, can I tell my happy part
no,
first?
No, you just made me think of something because
we watched it before we watched Mandalorian.
Nia and I said, oh, let's watch this short. And, oh, my
God. By the way, mine is not a Pixar short. My favorite thing is not a Pixar short, but continue.
It was so sad.
Is it about the lady who has the dumpling? It's supposed to be her son, and she eats the eats it.
That is awesome.
I've seen that one before, but that was a different one.
We saw that before we went to a movie.
The grandmother and the son and the potatoes with the rocket ship.
They were stuck. Yeah, it is god awful.
The potatoes and the rocket.
Well, here's the thing: they were stuck down in this hole, and you know they don't talk anything.
Yeah.
And you could tell they had been trying to make a ship or something that would launch them both
out
to get them both out. I'm not gonna tell you the whole thing, but oh man, it just pulls at your heartstrings. I was like, geez, Louise, who are making these? This is super sad, man.
Like I'm trying to watch Lion King, and I'm just over
here. I was like, I don't even want
to
watch the movie.
Have you noticed? Someone pointed this out to me. Then I'm gonna tell you what my thing is. Someone pointed out to me if anyone listening can name one Disney movie where no one dies, please do so. Like, I've not seen a Disney movie where no one dies. Where no one dies?
Oh, that's
no one dies in Peter Pan.
Hook dies. He gets eaten by the crocodile.
Well,
does he?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to think about that for the show.
But yeah, you may want to think about it. But let me tell you this. And we'll talk more about it off the air because it has to do with a project that I'm working on. So,
I just realized how many princesses were locked away in like Disney movies.
Okay, we're going in a completely wrong direction. But I just want to share this, and most of the audience, I don't know if they know or not, but anyway, this maybe can launch you into deeper research. But stories like Snow White and all that, those were not original stories from Walt.
The
Brothers Grimm, and those stories were grim.
They were depressing.
Walt, well, they were more than depressing. They were
scary.
They were scary. They were violent. They were some other things, but Walt was able to assume those stories and recreate them.
Yeah, have that movie. We have the Brothers Grimm movie, and it kind of ties into all of those in that movie.
Yeah,
it's not an old movie, but it's older, so you can watch the Brothers Grimm, and you'll kind of see, hey, like where they. Where you'll recognize like that? Oh, that's supposed to be Rapunzel, or that's supposed to be like the what's the one where the witch eats the kids and
Hansel
the candy
and
Hansel and Gretel? Like they have all kind of references in that movie.
And they had a lot of stories, and Walt went through their library. He purchased the rights to a lot of these things, and he was able to recreate them in a more family friendly way.
Yeah,
but he kept some of the elements.
Yeah,
and he changed some of the other ones. So a lot of people think, you know, Walt created all that stuff. He wrote all that, and, mm-hmm. and he did. Now, a lot of stuff he did.
Yeah.
A lot of stuff he did, but some of the stuff he did not. So anyway, let's...
So my favorite nostalgic thing that I found on Disney Plus is a little mini series called Tailspin. Daddy, you remember Tailspin?
Yeah.
I was browsing through Disney Plus one day, and I was like, I think I was started in like the Disney Channel stuff, so I had passed like Kim Possible, I had passed Lizzie McGuire, I had passed like Suite Life on Deck and all this stuff.
I forgot about Lizzie McGuire.
Oh yeah, it's all on there. And I saw Tailspin and I almost fell out my chair. I was like, oh my god, they have a Tailspin on here. Like, you'd be surprised the type of stuff you remember until you start hearing a theme song.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
So that was my wow moment when I saw Tailspin on there.
That's old school.
That's old.
Okay. I think I found three movies where no one dies.
Okay. We're going to answer the original question first.
Let's go to the original question.
Come closer to the microphone.
Favorite TV show or movie that you found that you were like super surprised and super psyched to know it was on Disney Plus?
I've been saying it the whole thing, the game plan or That's So Raven, because I didn't think there would A put
the original
shows on
That's So Raven?
Yes. Okay. I didn't think there would A put shows on there. I thought it would just solely be movies. Right. And even if it was, the game plan was like not what I was expecting. So
the game plan. Okay. So for me, you said you thought you knew what mine was.
Yes. Can I guess it?
I don't know, can you?
Mandalorian.
No. I didn't know anything about it.
That's new.
I'm talking about Mandalorian is new. And plus, let me take it back. I knew it was going to be on it because we saw commercials before it was launched.
Yeah.
That's how they were advertising Disney Plus.
I know, but when you first asked the question, you said, what was something you were excited about when you found out it was going to be on here?
Yeah. No, I was, but that was new. What I'm talking about is something that was old or something that had maybe fallen out of your memory bank. And when you saw it, you were like, oh, my God, I can't believe they have this on there. And for me, when I was a little boy, we would, you know, we had like three channels and all that jazz. So on Sundays, the Wonderful World of Disney would come on. And The World of Color and so many other Disney classics would come on, but it only came on once a week. And I remember some of the older nostalgic Disney stuff that I used to watch with my brother and with my mom and my granddad. And when I saw, there were a few things, but when I saw the Apple Dumpling Gang, it just took me back. Because I haven't seen that. Not only have I not seen that in 100 years, I wouldn't even know where to go to even try to see it. Like, if you type that in Netflix, it'd probably be like, what? What do you really mean? Like, what is the Apple Dumpling Game? But literally, it's in my watch list, and they have both of them there. And, man, it just kind of took me back. So, I think that's going to be it, guys. That's our... you have something else?
Oh, these movies. All right. So I have a question. Pocahontas.
The boyfriend dies.
No, he doesn't. Didn't he say...
Coco him dies.
Oh, yeah. He did die. Okay. What was it? Sandlot.
I did not see all of Sandlot.
Yeah.
No one died in Sandlot, right?
All
right.
Let's save this to the next podcast.
No, I was actually thinking about this.
I know. This is why I want to conclude. So, again, guys, thank you all for joining us here, episode 26 at My Disney Brain. I hope that we've been able to provide you with some really good feedback in terms of our thoughts around Disney Plus. If you don't have it, I would suggest, I'm not promoting, not getting paid for it, but if you are a Disney lover, if you have little kids, if you are a Disney family or about to be a Disney family, then you gotta have Disney Plus. I think for the price point and the fact that you get a 7-day free trial, it's not a contract to my knowledge. You can opt out anytime.
Yeah.
It's $6.99 a month just to validate what we're saying to you today. It's well worth it. There's new stuff coming out all the time. If you're a Marvel, Star Wars guy, man, all the stuff is there. Even those three Star Wars that you don't want to really ever see again, those are out there as well. But yeah, so today we've kind of given you some our feedback on what we think of the platform. You go to DisneyPlus.com, take a look at it there and see if it works for you. And hopefully it will. So, guys, we'll be back soon with episode number 27. We're going to begin before the end of the year. We're going to begin what I told you a while ago. We're going to start taking deep dives into Walt Disney World. And a deep dive just simply means we're going to really become historians of Walt Disney World and learn a lot more specifics, a lot more details about how the parks were made, built, formulated, developed, who took part, and why things are the way they are and why they are where they are. I think we'll probably start off with some of the resorts like Polynesian, Grand Floridian, some history behind there, and just jump into the parks. So join me on episode number 27 when we begin our deep dive into Walt Disney World, learning much more in detail, becoming official Disney World historians. Until then, please, as I always ask you to do, share our podcast link with a family, coworker, family member, coworker, or friend. We would certainly appreciate it. And again, just to reiterate, you can find us on Instagram and Facebook at My Disney Brain, B-R-A-I-N. This podcast was really fun to do with my two daughters, and they haven't been back in a while, so I wanted to get them back in the studio because the last time we did a podcast together, folks really enjoyed it. The numbers were really great. And speaking of which, guys, we have to come back and continue our podcast. The most popular podcast so far has been when we did the
Lion King?
No, not the Lion King, but we did our favorite memories. And remember, we were like, we could do, you know, several more. So we want to come back and continue that conversation because it seems like the audience really, really, really enjoyed it. So, again, guys, in the event that we don't record another show before the 25th, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. We hope that you have a fantastic Christmas. And if you are traveling, please be safe. And we will see you next week. Thank you for joining My Disney Brain.
The flower that blooms in adversity is the most rare and beautiful of all.
Look inside yourselves. You are more than what you have become. Remember who you are.
Of a far off place where a hero's welcome would be waiting for me.
Where the crowds would cheer when they see my face.
And a voice keeps saying, this is where I'm meant to be.
And so our journey comes to an end, but yours continues on. Grab hold of your dreams and make them come true, for you are the key to unlocking your own magic. Now go, let your dreams guide you. Reach out and find your happily